Hello everyone, I'm going to show you how to use ATLAS.ti, and these are the things I'm going to talk about: how to create a project and also how to upload your data, creating demographic information if you have demographic data, and also creating containers for your research question. I think it's very important. Last part is so important because you want to develop codes based on your research question. So creating containers for your research question is so important in this process. If you have any question, please let me know. This is the series of videos I'm going to do. This is the first step of uploading your document and then creating containers before you start the coding process. So let's go to ATLAS.ti. I'm going to use the desktop version of ATLAS.ti. I'll be also using the web version later, but this is for the desktop. So double click and open ATLAS.ti. And then, as you can see here, if you have existing projects, this is where you can see. If you want to create a new project, you click on New Project. And then you give it a name. For me, I can say Project Burnout. And you can give a description, right? It's not required, but if you want to do it, that would be great. Something short, like what I have here, this is about exploring the causes and solution of burnout. And then when you are done, you click on Create to create a project. When you click on Create Project, it will take you to the project. And the first step that you have to do is to bring the demographic information. But you have to prepare the data first. You have to make sure that you have prepared the data for that analysis process. So let me show you my data. So this is the data that I'm going to use. They are interview transcripts from five participants. The project is about burnout among primary healthcare physicians. So as you can see here, the purpose was to explore the causes and solutions of burnout among primary healthcare physicians. And these are the two questions that I want to answer. What are the causes of burnout? And the second one, what can be done to reduce burnout among primary healthcare physicians. This is my demographics, right? So you can see P1 to P5. I've given them the IDs. And then I have their age, gender, years of experience, and also ethnicity. If you want to get access to these documents, I have them in the description section. You can also download and use the document if you want to practice. So the first thing that you have to do is prepare your data, making sure that they are ready for the analysis. You have taken out any identifiable information from the transcript. So as you can see, let me open one of the transcripts for you to see. So I have my P participant one, I have demographics and their responses. Their names are not here, and I've assigned them labels P1 or participant one. And as you can see, these are the responses. When you finish preparing your data, the next step is to go back to ATLAS.ti and go to Add Document. And then you can choose Add Files or File. And then you can select. So let's go to the files that I have. I go to my data and I select all of them. I click on the first one, press on Shift, and click on the last one. You can bring them individually or you can bring everything together. So now you click on Open and this is what you're going to see. As you can see here, the document now is five. So I've brought all the five transcripts here. As you can see here, all the five transcripts are here. After that, you have to think about demographics. You don't have to bring demographic information if you don't plan to do some kind of further analysis based on the theme that you have to find out whether there's a connection between some demographic variables and the themes that came up. If you are planning not to do those analyses, you don't have to bring demographic information here. One way of bringing demographic information is to go to document groups. So what happened here is that the system sees each of the file as document, right? So, and if you interview five participants, you're going to bring five documents. So the document means participants. So now what you have to do is you are going to group the document based on the specific demographic information that you have. So let's go back to the demographic information. So we have all this information here, we can bring age, gender, years of experience, and ethnicity into ATLAS.ti. How do you do that? What you can do is you double click on document groups, right? You go to new and click on new group. And then we can start with the age, and you put a column there. You always have to start with the name of the variable, which is age, and then 37, right there. And then you click on create. Now, the first participant is 37, and we have created by a category of 37. So we have to now assign this to the document or the participant. So this one is for P1. So we click on this one. When you click on what you have created, all the document will be shown here. And this is where you can assign the variable value, which is 37, to the respective document or participant. So we want to assign this one to participant P1. So we just have to double click and it'll come to the left side, right? So this means that you have a group called age, and within the group, we have one person who is P1 who is 37. So we have to create another one for the rest, right? So we have to create another value, which is the age for the next participant. So how do you do that? You go to new, you go to new group, and then you put age there. Always type the variable first before you type the value. So the variable that is age, the value is 55. The next participant is 55. And then you click on that. And then you look for which participant, which is P2. You double click and then it's assigned. Whenever it's assigned, you see under size, it shows the number of participants connected to a specific value in terms of the variable values. So you do the same thing for the rest. So you go to new group, right? You type age. The next one is 70. And sometimes you can just create the groups first before you assign them, right? So we can create the new one, age. And then the next one is 33. New age. If you were given age group, it's the same thing. You type age and you provide the age group. Maybe 18 to 34, 35 to 45, or 44, 45 to maybe 65. You can do the same thing. So what you are doing is that you are creating groups so that you put the participant in those groups based on the demographic values that you have, right? So it's for participant P5. So we double click on P5. 70 is for participant P3. And then 33 is for participant P4. So you see how we have assigned participant to the values of the ages, right? The next one that you have to think about is the gender. The same process, you click on new group, and then you type gender, column, and then male, and then create. You're going to do the same thing for the female. So you are putting them into groups, gender, female. So after that, you group them into male and female, right? So when we click on gender, this one is, if you cannot see everything, you push, bring the cursor in the middle here and push it to the right. So as you can see here, female, we look for female. P1 is a female, you double click. P4 is a female, and P5 is a female, right? Now we group them. Now the next one is a male. And then when you click on that, you look for P2 and P3, right? They are males. Then we do the same thing for years of experience, right? So it's the same thing process. As you can go through, you create a group. So you create a group, and whenever you're creating a group, you bring the variable first, then column, and you bring the value, right? Or the group that they have to belong. So if like say years of experience, you bring the value. If it's gender, you bring the group, whether you bring the group, whether it's male or female. So that's how you're going to do it. The same thing for ethnicity. You bring the value, the ethnicity, you create a new and then new group, you put ethnicity there, column, and then we put African American, you put Caucasian, and you put Asian American there, and then you have the groups, and then you can assign them to those groups. So that's how you can do for that. Because of time, I don't want to go through everything, but let me show you how the final product looks like. Let me go back here and go to the ones I've already created. So as you can see here, groups, we have 15 groups. When you click here, you can see age, ethnicity. So we have two participants who are African American. Asian American is one, Caucasians are two, and we have three females. So when you go here, this is where you get the groups and the number of participants that are connected to your group. If you want to know who is connected to what group, you can click on the arrow there, and to show you see here, P1 and P4 are African American. So if you want to know the group members, just click on the arrow before the variable or the variable value, and you see the group members. And this one will be helpful, especially if you want to compare the males and female concerning a specific theme that came up. And I think this is a very good exercise for you to learn more about how to group files, or you can group participant. This skill can be transferred to, if you have document that you are analyzing, you can group the document based on maybe the location or the source of the document, or based on the duration, or based on when it was published, right? Maybe you are analyzing articles, you can do the same thing. If you are doing a focus group, because you have one file for each of the groups, you may not be able to create containers for demographics or group them based on demographic, because it's difficult to differentiate between who said what. So it's not appropriate, or it's going to be challenging to do this for the focus group, right? So normally you can group them based on maybe the characteristics each of the group has, right? Maybe you did a focus group with two organizations. So organization one, you create a demographic variable called organization, and then you indicate the group, organization one, and then the second group with organization two, and then you connect them, the file to those, or group them under those organizations. You'll be able to do that. But most of the time, when it comes to focus groups, you don't really do demographics. But it's possible for integrate groups for the collective way, not individual participants. So this is how you can create demographics in ATLAS.ti. So now that we are done, the next step is to create containers for the research question. So let's go back to the project that we were looking at. So let me open that project and then go to quote, right? Double click. So you can double click and then on quotes, and then this is what you're going to see. What you're going to do is that we're going to create new codes for each of the research questions. So we have two research questions. The reason why you have to do that, you want to create codes and put them under their respective research question, right? If you don't have research question, maybe you can use the objectives of the study to create containers so that you can organize the codes based on the objectives of the study. Some use the interview questions as a way of creating containers for the interview questions and then develop codes under them. I think that it's not the best practice to do that, because interview questions are meant to collect data from participants What you have to do is to have research question that you can go through the data, extract information from the data, and then put create calls and that and put them under the research question that you have. So for me, I have two research questions, one for the causes of burnout and one is for the solutions of burnout. One thing that you have to think about is to create containers for them. And before you create a container, you always have to think about labeling your research question, right? So for causes of burnout, I said for the research question that focus on the causes of burnout, I labeled as burnout causes, and the second one is burnout solutions. Let's go to ATLAS.ti and create containers for the research question that we have. So how do you create a container? What you have to do is that you double click on codes, and this is what you're going to show you the code manager interface, and then click on new, you click on code. And here in parentheses, you're going to say RQ1, and then you close it and say burnout causes, right? And then you can also create another one. So you can enter more than one instead of, closing, creating one and then going back again. You can create more than one code. So let's create another code for our container for the research question two, right? Burnout. So for your research question, just decide the label for your research question. It can be in between 2 to 5 words. It doesn't have to be perfect. The essence of doing that is to remind you of the question that you want to address, right? So burnout solutions. And then when you are done, you click on create. So you see here that I've now created two containers based on the research question. So when I go to the data, I develop calls and put them under their respective research question that I have here. But this is what I have for you for this video. The next video will be how to develop calls using ATLAS.ti. How do you identify information that is significant? How do you create containers or calls and put them under their respective research question? I'll be happy to show you how to do that in our next video. Thank you for your time.